The first question you always get is it BattleBots? And it's not BattleBots.
3 months ago, 6 months ago, we had no idea what would be going on this season, if we would be even be able to compete, if we would have students that could participate. You know, there was a lot of what ifs.
My name is Patrick McGuire, and I am one of the lead design students for FRC 125. FRC 125 is a FIRST Robotics Competition team. Every year we get a challenge, and in 6 weeks we build a robot to compete with for this challenge. The games are generally sports themed, you know, throwing a ball into a goal.
Unleashing and unloading again is 125, the Neutrons into that high efficiency boiler. Holy smokes, look at them go.
Prior to this year, we qualified every year since 2011. And usually it's not a big stressor for us. We just know we're gonna make it because we do well enough that we always do. This year it's a lot harder.
This year is the only year we're a little worried about qualifying. The way it works is that everybody is required to go to two district events. The points that you accumulate for those two district events set your ranking within the district. The top 16 teams in the district get an automatic bye to Worlds. There's still 3 more weeks of competitions where other teams can leapfrog us and get ahead of us.
We need to keep pushing ourselves. We need to get better, and we need to do that this weekend. So the challenge is to shoot these balls into that goal. So there's both red and blue balls, depending on which side of the field you're on. You gotta shoot in one color or the other. And then at the end of the match, we've got to lift ourselves up on those rungs. We have a pretty unique system to do that. This robot's called Free Fall. It's a little ironic because it can actually be in free fall for a second during the climb process. Most teams, they'll go from one bar to the next bar to the third bar. We skip the middle bar. We are currently one of the fastest, if not the fastest in the world at this. The Markforged part specifically really helped us here because we're using the continuous carbon fiber in them.
There's no one in FRC right now that's 3D printing their climber assembly for this year's challenge. People will see that, they'll learn from that. People know that we've done that because we're proud of that aspect.
The Markforged material. It's allowing us to make stuff that we didn't even think we could before. This year is really important to me because having done this for 8 years, like it's almost half my life, and this is my last year I get to do this as a student. I also missed out on the last 2 years because of COVID, so I really want this year to be special and to go out with a bang.
There's a couple of really hard things to figure out.
I know exactly like what holds us back, and it's just that we don't have space. A lot of teams that we strive to be like and compare ourselves to have facilities where they can set up a field that represents a full playing field and practice every day with the robot, make improvements. Our team has never had access to space like that. It's really hard in the Boston area. We financially can't go off and rent our own space. It's just not viable for us. So that's the thing that holds us back. That's why we're late bloomers, because once we get the robot on the field, there's usually a few things that show up that we have to shake out that we just weren't able to.
We're we're dead. Wait.
30 seconds. 30 seconds. 30.
We have can. We're dead.
I can't see you guys.
Alliance One has taken a field timeout that began 30 seconds ago. So we will resume gameplay. Final two in 5 minutes.
We don't have to reset climber.
Can I rotate this real quick?
Do we have battery? Do we have?
Yeah, they're coming. Gate is up on this side.
We need gap tape. Right? No.
How?
They didn't get gap.
We really want to win because it's our home turf.